Hey there, thanks so much for stopping by. My name is Lexi, and today I have a thrift haul to share with you. If you are new to my channel, welcome. I do love to share thrifting videos. I like to thrift for things for my home. I especially love vintage decor. I also like to thrift for things that I might be able to resell at a flea market booth this summer, as well as just other things, you know, for my family, my kids, all of the things. So if you enjoy that type of content, I would love for you to subscribe and stay tuned for future videos. So let me go ahead and jump right into this thrift haul. This past weekend, we did a little staycation, a town about a little over an hour away from our house. And we went and stayed and did all the fun things in that town that we don't usually get to do when we go there to do, you know, shopping and stock up on things. So it was super fun. I did have a little bit of downtime while my littles were taking naps. That I got to go and do a little mommy time at a few thrift stores that I've never been to before. So I am excited to share with you the things that I found. I found a couple of things at each store, nothing too huge or crazy, but definitely some fun finds. So I'm gonna jump right in. The first store I went to is sort of a localish thrift store. There's a couple different stores of the same brand sort of in that town. It's called the Dakota Boys and Girls Ranch Thrift Stores, I believe, all located in Fargo, North Dakota. So if you're there, check them out. They were super great. Definitely my favorite store, I feel like, that I went to. And my favorite find was this super cute little house. They're calling this a lantern candle holder. It does still have the new tag on it. I'm not sure exactly where it's from, but I just thought this was so cute. It was priced at $3.99, which I thought was a really reasonable price for it. I think this will be so fun for decor for all seasons. I can picture this for springtime with a little nest or some flowers or eggs in there. I can picture for Christmas time with, you know, little trees or ornaments inside of there. So I was super excited to pick that up for myself. I also grabbed this fabric. It says on here it's 1 1/4 yard by 54 inches. It was priced at $1.99, which I thought was a really great price. It's just really pretty, sort of linen with some gold and like turquoise on there. So I'm not sure yet if I will try and turn this into like a runner or even like a throw pillow. I thought would be super cute. So was excited to pick that up. I also grabbed this little board. So this store had a lot of things that came from Target. Mostly I think like the Bullseye area. So I'm not sure if they, you know, I know that Goodwill sometimes has a deal like with Target to get the things that they, you know, salvage. So I don't know if I'm guessing that these stores maybe have a deal with the Targets in that area. But so I found this little, it's chalkboard on the one side, and then it is sort of like the wood on the other side. Just has this little rope handle. This one does not still have the tag on it, but I feel like I saw something like this in the Target dollar bins a while back. And this was just 99 cents. They did have some of the other chalkboards there as well. I feel like there is one for like pregnancy where you could kind of mark down, you know, the month and things like that that you're at. I feel like there's maybe there's another one like for a baby too, where you could do, you know, their month, like, and take a photo with it type of thing too. But anyways, I just picked up this one because I thought the DIY possibilities were too great for just $1. So I'm not sure exactly what I'm gonna do with that, but for a dollar, how can you pass it up? Other things I picked up from Target were this t-shirt. So they had all their Easter stuff out. This is a dinosaur with bunny ears and a basket. It is a children's size large, which will fit my oldest son. I wish they had one that would fit my youngest son, but they did not. So like I said, this is from the Cat and Jack brand, and this was just $1.49. So I thought that was an awesome price for a brand new Easter shirt. And this shirt actually ended up being cheaper. When I walked in, I saw that the Valentine's decor was 75% off. But the person ringing me up said that all holiday decor was 75% off. So I got this and a couple other Easter items at 75% off. Had I known that, I would have maybe picked up a couple of other Easter things. But like I said, I, I don't know. That's what the person ringing me up said. But my impression from walking in the store was that it was just Valentine's stuff. So anyway, glad to have that shirt. I also picked up this adorable little bunny planter. I think he looks vintage, but I don't believe he is. I think the sticker underneath here, it says Midwest made in Taiwan. So, but I just thought he was really cute and I definitely have spring on the mind. So I grabbed him, again, to keep for myself. He was priced at $1.99, but he was 75% off. So 50 cents for him. And then the last two Easter things I got were these travel stationery kits. These again were originally from Target from the Dollar Spot. They were, I think it says $5 on there. A little hard to tell. They kind of tried to ink it out and cover up the thing, but I'm pretty sure that says $5. And so these were just $1.49. So I was really happy to pick these up. You get 5 note sheets and envelopes, a notepad, 53 stickers, an activity book, 3 mini markers, and a mini sticky notebook, all in this super cute carrying case. So I did pick up this one in this sort of design, and then this one with this little snail in this design to go into my kids' Easter baskets. And again, so they were $1.49 full price, and I got them for 75% off of that. So what a good deal. Like I said, if I would have known they were 75% off, I for sure would have picked up a couple other Easter things. They had lots of baskets and some decorative items and, like I said, lots of other things that I recognized from the Target Dollar Spot. But happy to grab those. And then the last thing I got from that store was this. Da-da-da-da. Dinosaur pinata. So he is super cool. And this pinata was, I think he was $2.99. Yeah, $2.99, which is an awesome deal if you've ever gone to buy a pinata like at Walmart or Target. They are super expensive. So to get this one for $2.99, I was super excited. This will be perfect for one of my children's birthdays. You know, it's always fun for this next summer. So was happy to pick up that guy. Moving right along, the next store I stopped at was a Savers. I really just found a couple of things. The first thing I found, I don't even know if I can show you the whole thing, it is this table runner. It is super long, and it's got the white and black buffalo check on the front and just the solid black on the back. This runner was $2.99, so I thought that was a great price. I do like to add a little buffalo check here and there. I think it goes really nicely with like a little bit of the like farmhouse rusticness decor that I have, as well as with like the vintage decor too. So $2.99, like I said, I thought was a great price. Definitely noticed that at Savers, a lot of the stuff was a bit on the high end. So like I said, I just picked up a couple of things. The other thing I picked up was this really cute little wire caddy. It almost looks like chicken wire. Not sure where this is from originally, but I just thought it was super cute. I thought it'd be really cute with like little mini mason jars in here, you know, just to store different things or display different things. So this was priced at $3.99. And I did actually get this for half off when I looked at my receipt. I realized that. I don't know if it was the right color tag or if there was like 50% off one item. I didn't notice any of that, you know, on their board when I walked in. But I did get half off of this, so that was a great deal. And then I did pick up one other blanket for my oldest son. He's actually sleeping with it, so I can't show it to you. But it is a homemade blanket that is made to like be like probably a twin size blanket. And then if you fold it up just right, it kind of folds into itself and makes a little pillow. My grandparents had one of those when I was a kid. And so when I saw it, I just thought it was really cute. It has little cows and chickens on it. Perfect for my son. So I did get that as well. It was $3.99. Okay. I did go to one Goodwill and just found a couple of things. The first thing I got was just this little wooden decorative piece. And so it's just made out of a couple like random pieces of wood. But I just thought this is so cute. And I think it's so nice to have little things to sort of, you know, add different heights to your decor. So I did pick this up. It was $1.49. My plan is it needs to be tightened, and then I will spray paint it either white or black, and I think that would be really fun to use in some decorative display. So I will either keep it for myself, or I might, you know, sell it in my flea market booth after I get it painted and upcycled. I also grabbed this little beanie. It is a CC design cap. Adult hats were $2.50, so I thought that was a pretty good price. These usually run between like $10 and $12 brand new, so I was happy to pick that up. And then the last thing I got was this little white pitcher. It is a false graph little pitcher, and I'm starting to keep my eye out for little white iron stone sort of reminiscent pictures to start a little collection. And so this piece was $2.99, so I thought that was a good deal, and I'm happy to add him to my little collection that I'm starting. And then the last store I stopped at, I don't even remember the name of it. It was a really small little store, and everything was really crowded and really kind of cramped, and it was difficult to get through the aisles. So I kind of went in and then tried to get out kind of quickly too. But I did just find a few items. The first thing I found was this little wooden candlestick. It did have a glass votive piece on top here, and I already recycled that glass piece. I will just, spray paint and distress this and go ahead and sell that on the flea market. So that was $1. Like I said, I think that would be really cute painted up. I did also grab this metal tray. I just love the image on here. You can see the little bumblebee with these red flowers and this little like plaid design on the bottom. It does have a little bit of wear and some scratches on it, but I think that totally just adds to the character. So this was priced at $1, and like I said, I was happy to pick that up. And then the last thing I found was this adorable jar with strawberries on it. I just thought this was too cute. I know a lot of people like to decorate with strawberries in the summertime, so I did pick this up to go ahead and sell at the flea market, and it was just 30 cents. So I thought, what the heck, it's super cute. I'll go ahead and pick that up. So that was everything I found on my little staycation thrift adventure. I thank you guys so much for watching, and I will definitely catch you in the next video. Bye.